Hey everyone, this is Diana over at Crafting Parties. So today I will be doing a Sophia the First face made out of craft foam, which I'm going to be using to put on the front of some goodie bags. So what I did was I printed the image on the computer and I cut it out. I cut out the eyes because I do those as well on the craft foam. So just so I know where the eyes go. Okay, and then I printed several of them, faces, just so I can cut everything that I need. So I cut separately just the face, which I'm gonna do in this color, which is gonna be for the face. And then I cut the hair, and that's gonna be done in brown. And then I cut all the little waves on the hair. You can either color those in or just highlight them or something. And then I also cut the crown, which I think I lost because I don't see it. Oh, here it is. And this is gonna be done in glittered craft foam white. So let's get started with the other piece. And you basically do the same thing for all of your pieces. Let's just speed this up so you guys don't have to watch me trace and cut. Now on this one, you do cut out the spaces for the eyes and the mouth, the eyelashes. You do cut those out on this one, or at least I do. So you trace those as well. Okay, so this would be the hair, and I'm going to trace that onto brown craft foam. Okay, so once you have it cut, what I do is I glue it onto the craft foam that's going to be used as the for the face, and then I'll show you what I do. So let's get this glued on there with hot glue. it in parts just so the glue doesn't get cold while I'm doing it. Okay, so once it's glued onto the craft foam, I take my face template, which is this one. So obviously it's not going to be exactly the same, but it's the little ear was a little off, but it's okay. So there, we fit it in there, and then we trace where the eyes go, where the eyebrows go, and the mouth. So you trace that onto the foam, and we are going to cut those areas out. So let me cut this piece just to show you. I don't know if you could see it on there. Traced the eyes, the eyebrows, the mouth. Okay, so we cut that out. There we go. There we go. Burr. And I just take a small piece, just enough to cover the area of the eyes. And the eyebrows. Oops. And we glue that to the back. Can't really tell, but yep, it's black on the back. And then we do the same thing for the mouth area, but that's going to be in red. So let me get a little piece of red paper. Or it could be pink, whatever you prefer. And this one doesn't have to be that big. It's just for the mouth. And we do the same thing. So now what you do, you take your template again. You fit it in there. And then you just trace. You just trace the bottom part, which is her face, just so you know where you're gonna cut. So now with the X-Acto knife, and then you go all around. You can do it with the scissors as well. Well, there you go. This is the way it looks on the back with the paper for the eyes and the mouth. This is the way it looks on the front. Okay. And now with the hair template, you see how I cut out all the areas where the hair goes, with the waves of the hair. I'm going to put it over my craft foam and I'm going to trace those as well. So they're all traced. And you can use a Sharpie, or you can use paint, or whatever you guys want to use to color it in or to highlight that area. The Sharpie. Okay, now we're going to do the crown. Okay, so you need a little piece of glitter craft foam for the crown. And you do the same thing, just trace it on there. Can I take a hole puncher? And we're going to punch out just a little hole up on just like this. My hole puncher is not that good. Now those little punches that you got at the end, we're going to use three of them. Okay, we're going to put these up on the top. Now we can put her together. So we take our purple part. You might need to cut it afterwards, just a little bit. Or you can actually do this first and then, just like we did with the face, you can stick it onto a piece of, glue it onto a piece of craft foam, and then we can cut on the sides. And you know what? That's actually what I'm going to do, just to show you guys. Okay, so we put some hot glue all around. And like I said, I'm using purple because the bags are going to be purple. You guys are going to make the bags another color, or you can use brown, or if you don't want to use anything, you don't have to put anything on the bag. And just like we did with the face, we cut all around. And there you have it. There you have it. So I'm not very good with making eyes. It's one of my struggles when I do paper bags. So what I do is I just print out the eyes on the computer. And then you just stick them on there. Okay, I was wondering why it wasn't fitting. Had it backwards. Okay, there we go. But do the nose. Now you can draw the eyes if you guys are good with drawing. You can draw them on there. I usually just do them this way. They look much nicer and but if you guys can draw, go for it. Okay, and then we put on her crown. And then I'm just gonna trim. And if you could see on the bottom, the little excess craft foam, I'm just gonna trim it just so it looks a little neater. And there we go. She's all done. Now all we need is the bag, and we'll put her in the front of the bag. And I have a video on how to make the bags on my YouTube channel. And you can put any character you guys like. I do all my characters the same way. I print out the image and I cut the pieces that I need. Trace them onto craft foam and cut them by hand. So, if you guys have any questions, let me know. Leave me your comments down at the bottom of the video, and I'll be more than glad to answer any questions you guys have. Make sure you like and follow so you guys can see my videos every time I post one. And feel free to share my channel.